We've been making use of that PGSQL tool for quite a bit throughout this course. Now it's time to actually install Postgres on your local machine and understand how to really interact with it. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Postgres on macOS. So if you are using any other environment, continue on to a further video where I'll show you how to set up Postgres on a different operating system. So if you're still here, I'm going to assume that you're running macOS. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is make sure that you don't already have Postgres installed. Believe it or not, sometimes you install Postgres, a long time goes by, and then you forget that you had ever installed it. It definitely happens. The first thing we're going to do is run a quick command at your terminal to make sure that you don't already have Postgres installed and running. So to do so, I'm going to open up my terminal and run PSQL, like so. Now, what we are hoping to see is something like command not found. That means that Postgres is probably not installed. If you see something that says something like cannot connect, or if you even see a further command prompt, that probably means you already have a copy of Postgres installed or possibly even running right now. If you already have Postgres installed, it's going to present just a little bit of a challenge. In the coming videos, I'm going to ask you to type in some different connection URLs, some different settings, and these different settings are going to change a little bit depending upon how Postgres was installed. So at this point, if you already have Postgres installed and running, I'd recommend you uninstall it and show and use the same method for installing it that I'm about to show you. Otherwise, it's going to be up to you to figure out some settings in the coming videos. All right, so having said that, there are two possible ways, easy ways, there are more than two ways, but two easy ways to install Postgres on a Mac system. We can either use a desktop application called postgres.app, or we can install it via Homebrew. We can also build from source or install from source. We're not going to cover those options. We're going to take a look in this course at making use of Postgres using the Postgres desktop application. This is definitely the easiest and best way to get started. Another nice thing about it is that it makes it really easy to start and stop the database. So if you ever decide that you don't want to work with Postgres for the coming weeks or months, you can very easily stop it and not have to worry about Postgres making use of resources like RAM or CPU time on your computer. To install Postgres using this desktop application, we're going to open up a new browser tab and go to that address right there. Quick note, if you ever get stuck in the coming videos as we're using Postgres on your machine and you can't quite figure things out, you can always reinstall Postgres. And you can reinstall it by following the uninstall directions at the postgresapp.com website. You'll just take a look at the documentation section and find the link in there about uninstalling. Okay, so I'm going to go to this page. And we'll see something like this up here. So immediately on this page, we're going to go to the Downloads tab. Once there, you're going to see a link to download this. Go ahead and click it. Just to save a little bit of time, I already downloaded this installer before this video. So once your download is complete, you're going to end up with a Postgres DMG file like that. You might actually have a version on there. Totally fine either way. Once you've got that download complete, we're going to run that thing and then do a classic little drag and drop over to Applications. We'll then eventually see a little progress bar pop up, like this one right here. And after a second or two, that's it, we're pretty much installed. Now before we start to interact with Postgres or anything like that, there's just a little bit more setup we're going to do. So back on the Introduction page, we're going to scroll down a little bit, and you're going to see inside of here step number 3. This command right here, you're going to execute it at your terminal, and that's going to allow you to run some different commands from the terminal to interact with your Postgres server. So we're going to copy that big command right there. We're then going to open up your terminal and run that command. After running that command, we're then going to restart our terminal or just open up a new tab. This is absolutely required. You must restart it or open up a new tab. And then you should be able to run PSQL, like so. So I'm going to run that. And you might see an error like this. Now, if you see the error like this, totally fine. All we want to do is make sure that we don't see something that says command not found. All right, so once we get to that point, we're then going to start up our Postgres server by opening up a Finder window. We're going to go to the Applications tab inside of it. There we go. We'll go to Applications. And then inside of here, we should see the Postgres app. So I'm going to double-click that to run it. And then we'll see a little window like this appear. So whenever you see this, it means that your Postgres server might be up and running. The first time you run it, you might have to click on the Initialize button on the right-hand side. And then that's it, we're good to go. Server is up and running. Once that is up and running, we can then go back over to our terminal, run PSQL again, and we'll end up getting kicked to another little command prompt like the one you see right here. Once you're in here, you can exit this little prompt. We'll learn a little bit more about what this is all about in just a moment by entering exit or backslash Q, or you can also hit Control D as well. So any of those, we could do a Q or just a quit. So those are the three ways that we could exit that PSQL shell. Okay, that's pretty much it. Everything is up, installed, and ready to go. Let's take a pause right here and continue in just a moment.